Hello, everybody. Today I'm going to be sharing a story time on the time a random stranger at the park took photos of minors, me, and my friends. Before I get into this, I just wanted to share that I have not really been recording lately or anything like that. I've been doing art constantly. I really think, not to toot my own horn, but I really feel like I've been improving a lot. I just haven't really been able to like show it because I don't like posting on Instagram because I hate bios. I hate having to write bios, but I have so much artwork that I'm so proud of. And I was talking about this with my friend, and like, I just have so much artwork that has a lot of decency that I should be posting. And I do sell commissions. You can find them on my Instagram and DM me on my Instagram if you want one. I have been selling them, but I've really improved since the first, like, the time I put up my commissions, and I haven't really been able to show it, so my commissions have improved a lot. So I'm going to start, this week is spring break for me. My birthday's on Monday, actually. It's currently Saturday, so this whole week, Monday through Friday, and all of the weekend, I do not have school, which is really cool. So I'm going to be posting a bunch of art TikToks, a bunch of art Instagram posts, a bunch of videos on here. I'm going to try to post 2 videos on here. For my birthday, I haven't gotten my presents yet because it's on Monday. But for my birthday, I got a drawing tablet, and it's the Huion one. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, but I'll link it down below. And I'm really excited to use it to make digital art. I actually filmed this video yesterday, so I don't have the tablet yet, and I still don't. But I will hopefully be coming out with a story time, and the next time I do this, I'll be filming it digitally, or I'll be doing my art digitally. Okay, so now getting into the story time. So I went to the park with 3 of my friends, and all 3 of them are siblings, and I went with their mom as well. So the oldest one of the siblings is now 13, but at the time was 12 because she just turned 13. So we're gonna call her 1. The middle child we're gonna call 2, and the youngest child we're gonna call 3. So the youngest child is currently 9, but was 8. And then the middle child, because this only happened like a few months ago, but there's a lot of birthdays. And the middle child is almost 11, but she's currently 10. So we go to the park, and I don't really go to this park often, but we go, we have fun. So we want to do this race, you know, classic race that all of these random children do. So we are planning to go up the stairs of one of the playgrounds, and then there's this big, like really big square metal thing, and then turn left to go down to the slide and go down the slide. So we go down this, so we go up the stairs. 1 and I are going first, and then 2 and 3 are gonna go afterward, and then we're gonna have like a heat final or whatever. So 1 and I go up first. We are running up the stairs, and I'm on the right, she's on the left. So no, she's on the right, I'm on the left, meaning I have to go through the slide first because there's only 1 slide, because I'm on the side closest to this. I'm on the side closest to the slide. So you can kind of envision that, hopefully. I don't know if my explaining is kind of crap. But we are running up the stairs, and then I'm about to go down the slide. Like, I'm sitting on the slide, my bottom's on the slide. I'm about to push down. And we hear this lady behind us, and I just want to tell you, she's an adult for sure. She had a, like, 3-4-year-old child, and we couldn't, it's not like she was just, like, younger than 18 or something like that, or she was just babysitting. This girl looked older than maybe 25, maybe in her 30s. So she goes, "Hey, watch out." And she has like this kind of accent. I don't know why that's important, but she kind of had this like accent. So we turn around, and there's this mom, and she looks at us with the rudest eyes. She looks at 1 mostly. Now, she's like, "You hit my child," to 1. And not even like, "You accidentally like touch my child, you skim my child, you hurt my child." "You hit my child." Like, as in, we literally took her child and threw her across the playground and slapped her. Like, and the child, you would think she's crying or something like that. If she was crying, I would be mad at 1. I'd be like, "1, why did you do that?" But the child was just playing on like another of the games, even more to the right. Turned back to us, like their back is to us, We couldn't even see the child. The child looked like she was deep in her playing, didn't look like she just turned. And why would she if she got hurt? And one, she does not like being blamed as a bad person. She does not like being the bad person. And I can tell you that. We know her really well. So she's like, no, I'm sure I didn't hit your child. She told me later on, one, that she actually hit her elbow on a metal pole, and that's all she felt. And even if she did hit the child, one is not tall, but she's not short. She's average. And this baby is like 3 times shorter than her. It's sitting down. So we would have hit her with like our leg or like the bottom of our ankle or something like that. And one swears, she's like, I'm sure I didn't hit your kid. I'm sorry if there's any misunderstanding, but I'm sure I did not hit your kid. Like, I promise you. And the mom just keeps saying, like, with the rudest stare, the rudest attitude, doesn't even seem that bad, but it really gets bad. And it was bad at that time. She's, like, yelling at us. Like, these random, like, 8 to 12-year-olds, she's yelling at them for something we didn't do. And by now, 2 and 3 were just up there confused as well. And she's like, you hit my child. I saw you with my own eyes. And the child wasn't even, like, I don't think the child even noticed the conversation, to be honest. So we, after a little bit of that, we just like, we don't want to fight back. We're not going to fight back with somebody in their 30s, an adult, maybe even a mom. So we go back and we sit down on this bench, and there's this woman next to us, and she looked like a mom. I think like maybe her 6-year-old kid was playing. She looked pretty young, but she was there. And she heard the conversation and asked us along the lines of, are you guys okay? Or something like that. And we answered yes, I'm pretty sure. And yeah, you could tell by the look on her face. She was concerned why this adult was screaming at us. Again, we were minors, we're children. We're trying to play on the playground. Now, there is a playground 2 steps away from the playground we were playing on for kids under, I think, the age of 5, because most of the things on the playground we were playing on were a little intense. Like, there was those high monkey bars and poles and stuff like that. So we say, okay, we should go tell her that. We should go give her, that was my stomach grumbling. I'm so sorry about that noise. Sorry. But we are like, we should go tell her that there's a playground right there because it might be safer for her child to play on if she did think we hit her child. So we go up to her and we're like, hi, we just wanted to say, even though we're pretty sure we didn't hit her child, I think something like that. I don't know if we exactly said that, probably not. But one goes, yeah, there's a playground right there. And she points to it. It's like, it's not even a step away. I can't even tell you. It's not something you go into your car and drive to. You don't even walk across grass. You walk 2 steps. And it's right in front of her eyes. It's blatantly right there. I'm like right there. I'm not even joking. It's not like a good like mile away or a good like even 10 steps away. So we tell her that and she gets so angry at us. She was like, I don't know why you came here to tell me this. You hit my child. I saw you. She can play on this playground. I don't even think she took in consideration what we said to her. I don't even think she brought up the playground like that. Yeah. So she's like, you hit my child. I saw you. And she kept interrupting us while we were trying to talk. We came there. We were trying to tell her about the playground. And right before we told her about the playground, she's like, you hit my child. I saw you. And we tell her the tip. And oh my God, her face gets red. Just, I don't know why. Maybe she was having a bad day or something, but it was scaring me. Like, I don't know. Like, I'm an Aries, so I don't know. I don't really believe in astrology that much, but the stereotypes of Aries kind of match me as an Aries. So you can imagine me. I was like, I don't want to get in trouble for something we didn't do. I obviously knew I wouldn't get in trouble, but still, I'm not going to let my friends get in trouble, and I'm going to stand up for what's right. So I come in, I'm like, yeah, there's a park right there. She gets mad at us. She just gets mad at us. So long story short, she gets mad at us. And she's like, where is your mom? And she's looking at one. My mom wasn't there. One's mom was there. And we just stopped. Like, she's like, I think she asked, where's your mom? Is your mom here? Or something like that. And we're not going to go have this 30-year-old lady tell one's mom and say, your child hit my daughter and said they didn't. And yelled at me. Like, I'm not accepting that either. So we're like, no, our mom's not there. And we don't go back to the mom. We're smart enough. This girl's eyeing us to see in case their mom comes, in case we go to one's mom. This girl's like watching us in case we go to one's mom and go sit there so then they can go and rat us out for something we didn't do. We go sit on the same bench as earlier. That mom's still there. And I think that the girl, the Karen, we're going to call the mom, this 30-year-old mom, Karen, and we're going to call the baby, baby. So Karen, I think, looks over and thinks that that's our mom, the girl from before who asked if we're okay. And she's not. She's not. We don't know her. She didn't even look like us. So I'm like, I believe you. I mean, 3 and 2 were like our referees to make sure we didn't cheat. And they swore also that they didn't see the baby being touched at all. So after a little bit, we are not going back to this lady. This lady's scaring us. We do not want to go to our mom. So I think that that Karen was watching us to see in case the nice lady from before is our mom. And then the nice lady from before's kid comes up, and then Karen just walks away because she knows that's probably not related to us or anything like that. It's just another mom trying to enjoy her time at the park. Literally, that's it. So after a little bit, we notice that Karen and her kid goes over to the ice cream truck. And we want ice cream, but by the time that they finish with ice cream, we're not going to go interfere with them. And by the time they leave and they finish the ice cream, or they go away from the ice cream truck, the ice cream guy is probably going to leave. They don't stay for long. So we're like, we can take advantage of this because their mom said we're going to have to go home soon. So we go and we play on the playground, and we go to the one behind the playground that we were playing at originally. We go to the one behind it. Then we were playing there for a good 5 minutes, and there goes Karen and her baby walking and coming. And there's a bench right across from us, right across. You can see everything. And guess who sits there? Karen and her baby. They are eyeing me like a hawk. And their baby is just trying to enjoy their poor ice cream. And we knew that we could play on the playground, not because they're not going to come back with ice cream in their hands. So we made the smart decision. So Karen and her baby sits there. I'm running out of time. But Karen and her baby sits there, and Karen takes out her phone. I don't think much of it because we're not watching her. We're playing. Then, you know, you can feel when somebody's staring at you. So we all feel that. We all turn to see Karen and her phone. I don't have a picture of it, but her phone is out. And it is like in selfie mode. It is out. And we're like, no, she's not. No, she's not. No, she's not. She's not. We move to the other side of the playground. I think we moved to another one. She glides her phone to go to the same one as us. I swear to God, we were freaking out. Now, we knew and we saw her starting to pack up. And we're like, no, she's not getting away with this. So this is where the photos come in. We run back to their mom. We confess everything. We're like, run, run, run. And this is like this whole little evacuation kind of situation. I take my phone. I run to like get their license plate. I don't even know where we were going with this. Like, I don't know what we were going to do. Like, try suing her? Like, what? But I don't know. All we knew was she was taking pictures of us. And that's illegal. And I don't want my pictures in her camera roll. This is a stranger. We don't even know her. It's not our guardian. It's not a friend. It's not our parent. We don't know her. We've never seen her in our life. So we go and get the phone and we run back, and their mom's trying to run, but like it's not as fast as us. And here are the photos. I'm going to blank out people's faces in case anything shows, and also the license plate, because even though the photos we took, they're so blurry, we can't even see the license. Somebody could like debug them. So we're taking pictures of the car, and she throws her child in the backseat. I'm not even joking. I wish I was joking. She throws her child in the backseat, and we have photos of it, and then gets in the car and zooms. And it's in a parking lot. There's so many other cars there, and she gets out so fast. It's like probably exceeding the speed limit for a parking lot, especially with kids around. And there was kids playing near there, like literally a safety hazard. She runs, and we take pictures, and I have a picture of 3 just in front of me, like in the shock face, but I'm not going to show their face for the safety, and probably not going to show that photo, but they were just shocked. And it was crazy all that day. People were just being rude to us, and you got to know we are nice people, so we would never do anything out of our right mind. So that was rude. So we take the pictures, and then they walk away, and oh my God. I think we went to somebody who was sitting next to them, and yeah, it was just a crazy experience. Honestly, wouldn't want to do it again, but I'm running out of time. That's basically my story. Yeah, thank you so much for watching. Follow my Instagram. Please, if you can, get a commission. If not, just support me by following. I love you guys so much. Thank you for coming. I really don't know the moral of the story. Don't let Karens take photos of you. How about that? Anyway, don't be accused of hitting a baby. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I love you. Bye.